One day we will have a office with a quiet space. Hey monkeys! Hey monkey! So I get asked, right, stop laughing at me. I can see you laughing at me. Hey monkeys, how you doing? Damien Keyes here. So I get asked regularly about press releases. How you're gonna send out press releases for your band to get your EP on blogs and vlogs and general other music industry publications. So I went and asked a bunch of people in the industry who know just a bit better than me, and I come up with a top 10 list. So here is my top 10 list for how you can send out a band press release. But before I start, I need to send out a massive, massive thank you to Claire, Neil, Pip, Helen and Laura, who've all sort of taken part and helped me with putting this information together. These guys know what they're talking about, and also the links are down below. The clue is, this is what they do for a living. Number one. What happened then? Number one, concise is key. Now all of the guys I interviewed say they get up to 200 emails every single day, and a lot of those are press releases. So you need to treat their time with respect. You just need 3 to 4 paragraphs to get all of the information across and let them do their job. Number two, relationships. This is about building relationships over a long period of time, not just for this EP or release, but for the next one and the one after that, and potentially, should this band go wrong, but the next band as well. This is a long-term game that you're playing. You are not there to just send stuff to people and say, print this, put this in your blog, listen to this, because that will not get you anywhere. This is about human contact, so your job is to build a relationship over a long period of time. Number three, the headline. The headline is the first thing they're gonna see, and if they're getting 150 to 200 emails every single day, you have gotta do something that grabs their attention, that wants them to open that email and read that press release. The headline is really, really key. It's the first impression before you start getting into information and facts and pictures and links. So make sure you have an attention-grabbing headline. Number four, working links, working hyperlinks. Now I know this sounds really, really obvious, but I know how frustrating this is because this happens to me all of the time. When I say to someone, send me through your band link, and they send it through and it won't open because it's spelt wrong or it takes me to a different place. It's so frustrating, and it's got to be rule number one. You have to come across as professional, and if your links don't work, you will not get past stage one. Number five, high-res pics. Now, pictures are crucial in this industry. So not only do you have to have very, very good pictures, but they have to be high-res. You can't have small thumbnails which you've pinched off your website to send them. Again, treat this professionally. Send high-res pics and make sure you can send through a portrait and make sure you can send through a couple of live pictures as well. This is about telling a story and showing off the band in the best light. If you don't have high-res pics, it is very, very doubtful you will get any further than the first opening email. Number six, research. Now this was a big one amongst everybody. If you are gonna send through a single, an EP, or an album, make sure you've put the time and effort into researching who you're sending it to, which blog or vlog that you're sending it to, and you have some kind of knowledge that it's going to fit together. Because there's nothing worse than you sending out your metal album to a blog that reviews acoustic covers. It just makes them feel that you haven't bothered. And if they feel like that, not only will they not review this, but they probably won't review anything that you ever do ever again. So do the research, put the time in so that you can get the most out. Number seven, the Kipling principle, the who, what, when, where, and why. Now the why is not that relevant in this instance, but the other things are crucial information for you to get into your press release as fact. Who are you? Where are you from? What's the story? When is it out? Who, what, when? Who are you? Where? Who are you? What? What is this? What's this for? Have you got an EP? Is it a single? When is it released? And where can people find it? This is crucial information that should all be in your press release, and it should be stated very clearly. Tip 8, the week of the release. Now this was an answer that was slightly differing amongst all of the guys. But most of them agreed that if it was sent too early, it would get lost because there's too much news coming in every day. And that's what this is. Don't forget, this is news, up-to-date news. So if you're 2 weeks in advance, then it's not news. It will be news, but it's not news yet. But also, if you send it too late, if you send it on the day that it's released, then whilst it is news, there's a good chance that it will get lost in the momentum of everything coming through. So your best bet is around about on the week of that release is when you want to get in touch. Now, all of them also said it is okay to chase up after a couple of days, but please don't send an email and then chase it up within a couple of hours. Give yourself a few days leeway, so then if you are going to chase it up to see if it's going to go in, you won't piss them off. Tip 9, favors work both ways. There's nothing worse than when people are always asking favors of you and not getting anything in return. So, what have you got to do? Well, apart from being professional and give them everything that they need to make their job and life as easy as possible, but you need to make it very, very clear that if you get something out there, it's going to go on all of your social media to build their profile just as much to build yours. You've got to remember, this is building relationships long term, and this is about a bit of a collab, so you need to help them as much as they're helping you. And number 10, be human and have some manners. Don't forget, when you're sending an email, hi, how you doing? How was your weekend? Been on holiday? Any new music that you can recommend? Or saying to someone, I read that blog and it was absolutely fantastic. I wonder if you wouldn't mind having a listen to our stuff. No demands, conversation. This goes so far. Don't forget, this is what people do all day, every day. They want you to be human just like they're human. They want to have conversation. They don't want someone to just send stuff in and say, listen to this. It just sounds like a demand. So treat them like humans. Be human and have nice conversations. So that's my top 10 tips on sending out a band's press release. Thank you so much to everyone that took part in this. It's actually been a great learning curve for me as well as for you guys. All their links are below, so if you have got an EP, a single or an album coming out, then check these guys out. Make sure you pay attention to the top 10 tips that we just talked about before you send anything through, but thanks to them. Make sure you like, you subscribe, and comment below. And more importantly, come back tomorrow because we'll be doing this all again.